Hi there folks, in today's demonstration I'm going to show you how you can build an Azure function that can compress or zip files from Base64 content. So this scenario is useful if you want to compress files from different sources, whether that be SharePoint or OneDrive or third-party APIs, blob storage, etc. There isn't a native functionality in Power Automate to do this, but not only that, I'll show you how easy it is to build an Azure function so that you can extend the functionality of Power Automate and keep it all within the Microsoft ecosystem using Azure. So if that's something that interests you, please make sure you like and subscribe, and without further ado, let's jump into my demonstration. So I'm here on the Azure portal, and the first thing that I want to do is I want to create a resource for a function app. So I can click on the create a resource button here, or as you can see, I have the function app because I've already created a function app in the past. So I'm going to go ahead and click here, and this will allow me to see all the function apps that I have on my tenant. So at the moment I have none. I'm going to create a new one, and then it's a case of working through this wizard. So you can see I already have a subscription. It's my free subscription that I have for all my development work. I've got a resource group which I need to choose. In this case, I'm going for mine called Azure Automation, and that's how we group together all the different resources and makes it easy to filter them. And I need to give that function app a name, which will then give us the prefix or the URL for our REST API. So this function name, I'm going to give it the name of Demo Birds zip function. There we go. And then I just need to work through the rest of the options. So it needs to be in .NET because it's some C# code I'm implementing, and everything else here, consumption is how I want to be charged for this, and everything else is pretty much default. You can work your way through these settings and make changes if you see fit, but I'm going to keep everything as default and we will review it, and hopefully there'll be no errors and I can create. So after about 15-20 seconds, we should get a new function app being deployed and ready for us to implement some code. So the deployment now complete, I can click on Go to Resource, and that will now allow us to go and implement some code for our new function app. So from our newly created function, you can see that we have the ability to create a function, and I'll go ahead and click on that. And we have another wizard where if we select the HTTP trigger, we can then trigger using REST API from PowerShell or Power Automate or Logic Apps. And if I scroll a bit further down the screen, we can see that our function has a name. So let's call this zip files, and we can change the authorization level. But for this, I'm going to leave it at function, and we'll hit create. So with this new function created, if I go to the code and test tab on the left hand side, we already have some sample code, and we can use the test and run pane, and you can see there's a sample body we're going to be posting to this new REST API, and if I hit run, it'll run this code and give me the response. But we want to be able to, of course, zip some files. So I have a blog post and I have the code that I've written using ChatGPT to zip some files based on an array of file names and Base64 file encodings. So if you jump across onto that blog, the URL will be in the description below. You can copy that code and simply overwrite the code that we have in here, the sample code. And then when we go into test and run, it'll run this new code and allow us to zip some files. But before we do that, I'm just going to hit the save button. So also included on my blog is some sample body input, because of course we don't need an object with a key called name, we need an array with the file name and also the file content. So if I overwrite that with a sample from my blog, we can see we have a couple of files in here that contain a text file and also an image. And you'll note that both of the file contents are in Base64. So that's very important when you're passing the data into this function app from Power Automate or from PowerShell, etc., that the string is encoded in Base64. So if I go and test that and run it, what I should get is a 200 status. And it looks like that's what we've got here at the top here, a 200 OK. And you can see the file content here is actually the response, including the content of a zip file. So if we were to save that into a file now, call it .zip, we'd be able to open it up and it would have a couple of files in it, a text file and an image. So that's pretty much all we need to do to set up our function app. There is a get function URL at the top here. We need to copy that for our Power Automate flow. So I'll go ahead and do that now. And then let's jump across and build out our flow. So from within Power Automate, if we go ahead and add in an HTTP action, we can then send a post of the data, the body, into our new HTTP function that we've created. So I'll choose the HTTP action. I can paste in that URL that I copied earlier, change the method to post, and the thing I need to include is the body. So if we think about how we do this using a folder of files, we'd go and list all the files within a folder. We can then go and get the file content of all those files in the folder, and then we can create an array just like we saw in the blog post, or as we did in our test on the Azure function within the Azure portal. But if we're just looking to test this very quickly and create a zip file, again, using that sample data that's on my blog post, if I paste that in, it's exactly the same that we saw before. It's got two files, it's got the text file and it's got the image file. And all we need to do is to save the output into a create file action. So I'm going to go here and search for create file. I'm going to use the OneDrive action because I've got my OneDrive already open in another tab. And I will choose a folder which happens to be called a folder to zip. And if I give the file a name, so we'll call this a new zip file dot zip, don't forget the extension. And then the file content is just be based on the body. So I can select the body there. And we now have a flow that will take an array of objects, which is our file names and our file content. And then with the output, it will save that as a new zip file. And we've created a zip, all from Power Automate using our new Azure function. Once we've tested it, I'll show you how we can expand that and go and create that array dynamically. So I'll now test this flow. The process runs extremely quickly. We can see if we pop open the history for the HTTP action, we've hit that new URI that's been created for our function. We've passed in the body with the text and the image, and we've finally got a create file that saves a new zip file to a folder to zip. And if I jump across onto my OneDrive and then just refresh this screen, we can see we now have a new zip file .zip. Which I can open. It contains a text file, it contains an image file, and if we go ahead and download that and open it, we can see now I have that new zip file. And if I open up my text file, it contains the text hello world, and if I open up our image, it's a picture of a peach. Don't ask me why, but when I searched for Base64 images, I got a picture of a peach. So there we go. So let's now see if we can make this dynamic and actually zip up all of the files that are contained within this folder called a folder to zip. So we will zip up our newly created zip, include the Excel document and the Word document in a newly created zip file. So back over into Power Automate, I'll put our flow into edit. And the first thing I want to do is to add in an action to list the files in the folder. So we'll search for list files and folder. There's the OneDrive action. And of course, I'm doing this for OneDrive. You could be getting files from a secure FTP, from an FTP, from an API. It doesn't really matter as long as the file content is in Base64. So I'll choose my folder location, which is my folder to zip. That will list all my files and give me an array of all those files. Then what I want to do is I want to get the file content. So I'm going to use the fact that Power Automate will automatically put me into a loop if I choose get file content. And then for the file ID, if I use the dynamic value for ID, you'll see that we'll get put into an apply to each, because of course it could be one or many files. It's returning an array or a table of those files in the folder. So we're now looping through all those files, we're getting the file content, and then we want to create an object. So I'm going to do that by adding an action and using a compose. Now you've got two options for creating an array. One is actually to initialize a variable outside your apply to each. The other is to use a compose, and you can just go and specify your object structure. So an opening and closing bracket like so. And then we've got those two key value pairs, the file name and the file content. Now, like before, I'm going to copy and paste the sample that I had on my blog post, but I'm going to strip out the first object, which is our second file. So I can copy everything between the squiggly brackets and delete that. I also want to make sure I delete the comma there. So I've now got a single object in an array, but I also don't want an array. I want just an object, so I can delete the square brackets. So tidying things up a bit here. we now have everything that I require between two squiggly brackets. The alternative, of course, is just to type in file name in double quotes, file content in double quotes, put semicolons after them, and just ensure you've got a comma after your first key value pair. So at the moment, this is fixed. The file name and the file content is fixed, but we can highlight the text file.txt. We can go and choose some dynamic content. We can go and look for the name of the file. So there we go, the name of the file, because we're in an apply to each, it'll appropriately get the name. And then because we're using the get file content, again, we can go and search for dynamic content, choose file content, and we've now created an object in the structure that's required for our function app. It has the key for the file name with the dynamic name, and it has the key for the file content with the base64 encoding. Or does it? It just so happens that this file content is also an object, so it will fail. The correct expression for OneDrive, and there are differences between OneDrive and SharePoint, is to include a key called content, $content. So I actually need to change this file content expression. So if I click the cross and remove that dynamic value, I can go into the expression editor, I can go into dynamic content, I can choose file content, which gives us that expression that we saw, but I need to also add, in single quotes and the square brackets, $content. So if you have problems with this, make sure that the value that you're sending into this object is base64. And the best way to find that out is, if it fails, is to look back over the flow history. And we can maybe have a quick look at that once we've run this flow. So I'll go ahead and add that. That is now the correct expression that will get the file content in base64. So next up, we need to make a change to this HTTP action. Of course, at the moment, we've got a fixed body because we tested it with that sample body from my blog. We can delete that and we just replace it with an expression. So if you had a variable, you could put in your variable as dynamic content, but because we're using a compose, we can type in the expression outputs and we can put in single quotes the name of our compose action. In this case, it is compose. If you called it compose object or compose something else, then make sure you reflect that appropriately. But what this will do is it will take all of the instances of the compose within the apply to each and turn it into an array. Because remember, this body here is expecting an array of objects, which is basically a table of rows with the file names and the file content. So I'll go ahead and hit add and we can save and test. So the flow completes successfully. Within a couple of seconds, we've got all the file content, listed all the files from the folder. We've then got the file content here within our loop, which we can see there are three because it will have got that Word document, the Excel document, and also that zip file that I created. The compose we can see is just, if we show the raw input, is the file name and the file content. And this is the important bit, making sure that it looks like this. It is base64 encoded. It's not some other funky string that you're passing if you're getting any failures. Remember I said we needed that $content. If we look at the output of the get file content and we show the raw output, we can see that we have our body and it's in particular this key that we want to send. So that's why I changed the expression from body to body and then the question mark, square brackets and single quotes, $content, because we want to get this base64 so we can pass that across into our Azure function. So everything's run fine. If I jump across onto my OneDrive and do another refresh, I realize that I haven't changed the file name, so I have actually overwritten our original zip file with a new zip file that should contain both the original zip file and the Excel document and the Word document. So we'll go ahead and download that, have a look. We can see we have the new zip file, we have the Excel document, we have the Word document. And if we do download that and just test it, we can see the new zip file has those three files. The original zip file within the zip file has still got the image of my peach and also the text file. But if we go back to the root of that zip file, we have the Excel document, which contains some information about Logic Apps versus Power Automate. And if I load up the Word document, it contains the content of my blog post that I've shared with you. And so there we have it. We have built an Azure function. It's allowed us to zip files based on Base64 content. We've tested and built it within the Azure portal, and then we brought it into a Power Automate flow that's therefore enabled us to zip up files and save it to our final location. As always, thanks very much for watching. If you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you again sometime soon. Thanks for watching. Cheers.